confusion about what's going on. Yeah. A timeout. There was an elbow thrown.
That was the first shot he threw. It looked like it was an elbow.
Just explain to us what the problem with an elbow is in kickboxing.
Yeah, those are illegal. No elbows, throws, or grappling in a flyweight kickboxing match. Let's take a look at it. I don't know if he was trying to throw it as he was maybe throwing his hand. You can see him fake, and then, yeah, that's very clearly an elbow.
Yeah.
That is pretty clear.
Switching from Muay Thai to kickboxing.
You know, it's tough, Steve. Like, he's done, you know, he's 30 match veteran as far as Muay Thai is concerned, multi-time world champion. Looks like he's being issued a yellow card.
That seems perfectly legitimate, doesn't it? Very, very early on in this contest. Nobody believes that was premeditated, that's for sure. But the barrage continues, and now we're erupting. And Mahmoudi got his kick almost caught up in the circle wall there.
Mahmoudi's trying to get something back. He's immediately pressing Petchdam back, trying to throw big shots. Petchdam's trying to answer, but the range is so... Man, it's hard to deal with. Look at those kicks.
You get on the end of those long legs and they do get pushed back into the circle wall, just as Petchdam was there. Personality that we saw coming into the circle a few moments ago, Mahmoudi is showing that it's about focus on the task at hand. He lost a bit of that focus in the first few seconds, but he seems to be recovering it now.
Huge left kick, pay close attention to it. Mahmoudi does not seem fazed by it. Standing right inside that kicking range, throwing huge shots.
He's a tall, tall, rangy man, and that is a big threat for Petchdam at the moment.
He's a gigantic flyweight, 178 centimeters tall.
Oh, good left hand from Petchdam. That landed flush.
Anything that comes off of Petchdam's left side is seriously puts you at risk.
Left hand again, but he eats a left hand in exchange.
Nice catch and counter from Petchdam now.
Very well executed indeed. Spinning back into the rib cage. Step backwards. Back onto the breach though.
Mahmoudi hasn't thrown any spin attacks yet. He's been very conservative. This first round, he's been throwing big, heavy straight shots. There it is.
World Championship contest. 5 3-minute rounds, and we're into the final 20 seconds of the first.
See how patient Petchdam is. Very slow, methodical steps back before he fires off something to his left side.
Right hand from Mahmoudi was crisp, and it shook the face of his opponent. Final moments of this opening round, and even with the injury timeout, that has absolutely breezed by it.
What an open at the edge of their seat right now.
Right jabs from Petchdam, and they will be a little bit short unless he gets right inside those four arms of Mahmoudi.
See, Petnam's trying to counter-strike, he's trying to back up. That left side as Mahmoudi lets go of a combination.
Just prior to that, there was a spinning back kick that if it had landed, might well have finished the contest.
Nice straight left hand to the body there, landed by Petchdam.
Just looking up at these two athletes, the overriding feature is Mahmoudi's height. For a flyweight, he really does pack it off right into that frame. And he smiles at Petchdam. They exchange brutal kicks.
Big left shots landed by Petchdam as Mahmoudi throws that right kick.
Oh, nice right hand from Mahmoudi. Counters very well and sends in combinations. Very solid right hand from Mahmoudi.
Mahmoudi's doing a good job of checking that left kick. He's blocking a lot of these shots thrown by Petchdam. As he got like those combinations that he lets go, Petchdam lands a nice jab there on the exchange.
Petchdam really is taking these big punches well. Seems to have a very solid chin. throwing the left hand, and it landed bang on the beard. The right hand grazed Petchdam's face. Had it landed flush, that one could have made a difference too.
I like how he follows it up with the uppercut. So he throws the big right, and comes right up underneath the right uppercut.
Piercing kick to the head from Petchdam. That left leg working overtime. Fakes. And then throws.
You just see the guard of Mahmoudi. He's done his homework. He knows that that left kick is coming. So he's got his right hand glued to the side of his head as he spins there.
That spinning back kick, which did connect. Quite a power that the one we saw a few moments ago. Look to unleash. Good left hand for Petchdam to throw. A nice combination there. Scoring punches. 42 seconds left of the second round.
Let's skip in. He throws the right kick, and he throws that punch right after it. Still off balance. He's got all his weight on one foot. Very tricky striker is Mahmoudi.
30 seconds left in the second round.
And half minute. Oh, they hit it. Beautifully executed by Petchdam. They exchange kicks high up there on the body. Rushing forward, throwing the right hand, and two more.
It's interesting when Petchdam catches the push kick, you have to let go of the foot. You can't hold the foot and strike at the same time. You have to catch the foot, let it go, and then you can strike. Under kickboxing rules, you have to two very close rounds.
Perhaps Mahmoudi doing the slicker work in the two, but I agree with you, very close. 10-3 assistant is what these judges will use to find their winner.
Nice left hand landed by Petchdam there.
And this work for Mahmoudi follows it up with another one. Petchdam doesn't seem that stupid body.
Look there, as he was stepping forward.
Mahmoudi does not throw much that misses.
It's pinpoint accuracy, Steve. Look at that combination, jumps into the skip knee, lands the right hand.
I think Mahmoudi is complaining about another elbow. Certainly complaining about something. The referee has noted it. Petchdam's work mirrored by the fans here at the Impact Arena. With cheers of joy and support. But at the moment, their man is slightly behind, I fancy. Good two-handed work from Mahmoudi.
These guys they know each other so well. They have done their homework. They're blocking a lot of these shots. But it's the second and third shot that you have to pay attention to. Watch, they'll throw the right kick or the left kick, but then it's the follow-up combination that lands.
Seems to have everything in his arsenal. Algerian spinning back this though as well. And it landed. Doesn't waste much, does he? Beautiful in the counter-attack there. These rounds are flying by. We are entering the final 40 seconds of round three. And Mahmoudi steps up the pace once more. And I have to say, these Thai fans are appreciating the work that the Algerians do.
Two good left hands landed by Petchdam.
Another heavy right for Mahmoudi.
Starting to read what Mahmoudi's starting to do.
Lunges forward, lands a short right hand, and Petchdam lands a super left. But Mahmoudi came back next.
The chick is beautiful, though. He's able to time that left kick. You know that's coming.
Mahmoudi's upset is warning
about. Well, that's what the referee's warning about. It's the way that Petchdam's catching it, and then he's striking, so he's not letting go of the kick. You have to release the kick once you catch it if you want to strike.
It's Mahmoudi who has the yellow card. An incident seconds. The match is super close. Beautiful hand combination. Run by Mahmoudi. Wonderful stuff from both of these men. Petchdam is relentless. He will not back off despite the quality that is being aimed at his head. Petchdam's wearing his ball.
At this point,
our athlete is unable to continue due to an unintentional illegal strike. We will now turn to the judges' scorecards.
We have started the fifth round, and therefore the judges will make a decision. No announcement has been made, but Petchdam seems to think he's won it.
I think that's a premature celebration.
I think you're right.
They're going to the announcement.
The one Flyweight Kickboxing World Champion!